Hi there, I'm Blackbright and I'm going to do a quick video. Well, I hope it's quick. So if you're first time at my channel, subscribe, like, share, and thank you for my subscribers. Yes, I appreciate your comments. I can't answer all of them, but I can answer some, and those I do. Anyway, what I wanted to talk about is Chagos Islands. Now, I don't know how many of you know about the Chagos Islands being a part of the British territories, in the sense that the Britain ruled it and overtook it and stuff like that. I didn't know that. And so I'm sure that, I mean, we'll have those of you who are quite knowledgeable about history and stuff. I'm not one of them. I'm learning as I go along. Anyway, I learned over the last couple of days, they've been talking about the residents or the generations of Chagos. They call them Chagosians. And they're people, they're descendants of the people from the Chagos Islands. And apparently, I think in the 1920s, the British rule took over the islands because they wanted to set up a US military there. And what they did, a US military base, and what they did, they kicked out all the residents, thousands of them. And so some of them ended up here, and some of them ended up in other parts of the world, Seychelles and whatever. Anyway, what's happening now is that they're telling them that they can't get their British citizenship because they're not... some of them weren't born in the Chagos, even though they kicked them out. They kicked out their parents out of the Chagos Islands. So as a result, some of them were born in the Seychelles, some of them were born elsewhere. But they were born in those countries because the UK kicked them out in order to set up a US military base. So I didn't know about this. So these people are in the UK, these Chagosians. And they have children, and they're having problems with children. They're allegedly up for deportation, some of them. They're a bit like the Windrush. The Windrush were generational with regard to the Commonwealth and British territory, and British owned it and British rule. And then they decided, Jamaica went independent and other islands went independent in the 1960s. And as a result, all the rules changed. The Seychelles, that went independent. And because it went independent, I think in 1940, the UK has no loyalties to the Seychelles. So as a result, the people who got kicked out of Chagos Islands are now in the UK. They cannot get their British passports because they weren't born in Chagos Islands. They were born somewhere else. And as a result, their children weren't born in Chagos. They were born in the Seychelles. Very, very complicated. And so because they're in the UK, because UK booted them out, they're now telling them to go back home. Whew. Anyway, I'm going to read it so it makes it all sense. I've just kind of, that's my rough understanding about what's happened. But let me just quickly, hopefully quickly, read through it before my door knocks. Okay, Janet Valentini is a descendant of the Chagos Islanders who were expelled from their homeland to the UK to make way for the US military base. Like the Windrush generation, Chagos was at one time under British rule, and the Seychelles went independent in 1940. She faces the prospect of her daughters, Taniela and Nesta, being deported. Janet was born in the Seychelles, and so was her daughters. Second-generation Chagosians, like Taniela and Nesta, are in a legal battle. They're not eligible for British citizenship because neither they nor their mother was born in the Chagos Islands, which was a British territory. But that is only the case because their descendants were expelled from the islands by the UK to make way for the military base. The expulsion was found to be unlawful by the International Court of Justice earlier this year. In the 1940s, the Association of Seychelles Taxpayers protested against the UK's management of the islands. Parliament then voted for independence, a new constitution was then finalised in 1976, and Seychelles became an independent republic within the Commonwealth. 1814, The Chagos Islands became British territories in 1966. The UK allowed the US military to build a military base, displacing thousands of islanders. The Chagosians have grown accustomed to the regular legal battles in the London courts, as they have fought for the right to return to their homeland for many years. Only one case has ever ruled in their favour. In 2000, the British High Court ruled that their mass deportation was illegal. In 2019, the UK was ordered to hand back the islands to Mauritius by a UN court. Although the majority decision by the International Court of Justice in The Hague is only advisory, it represents a significant defeat for the UK. Decades of forced exile have dispersed Chagossian communities around the world. Most live in the UK, Mauritius, or the Seychelles. None have been allowed to return. Monday's judgment, that's just Monday gone, the 29th, is it, of July 2019, by the ICJ, has raised their hopes that they may eventually be able to return and reclaim their homes. British passport holders from the Chagos Islands are being systematically targeted in a shameful attempt to have them removed from the UK, the Observer can reveal. The revelations expose a fresh dimension of the UK's hostile environment, showing that the strategy also persecutes passport-holding British citizens of colour. A series of interviews corroborated by the internal government emails reveal that the sizeable community of British Chagossians in Crawley, West Sussex, have faced a lengthy campaign putting pressure on them to leave the country. They say they have felt intimidated by hostile officials. British Chagossians say that the local council often pay for flights to the Indian Ocean rather than provide them with housing assistance in the UK, which is potentially unlawful. Others allege that council officials aggressively told British passport holders seeking housing assistance that they should go and return to the Seychelles or Mauritius. Okay, so they kick them out and now they want them back. The same what they're doing with they did with the Windrush. Take them out of their country and then they boot them out when they don't want them. Satbir Singh, Chief Executive of the Joint Council of Welfare of Immigrants, said this is another shameful reminder that the hostile environment is regularly weaponized against people of colour and must be scrapped to ensure all Chagossians have a right to stay and a scandal like this is never repeated. I mean, the things that you learn. You've even heard of Chagossians. Claire Collier, Advocacy Director for the human rights group Liberty, said the apparent targeting of British Chagossians is deeply worrying, potentially discriminatory, and symptomatic of the mission creep of the government's hostile environment. One British Chagossian described the approach of Crawley Borough Council as racist and said many had been affected. The saga began in the late 1960s and early 70s when 2,000 strong population of Chagos Islands was forcibly moved by Britain to allow the US military to establish a strategic air base on the largest island, Dio Garcia. Islands were exiled in Mauritius and the Seychelles, 2,000 kilometres away. And in 2002, native Chagossians and their children were given the right to British passports. Oh! Since then, more than 3,000 have immigrated to the UK, the majority settling in Crawley. So how can they boot them out then if they've got British passports? Wow, don't you learn something new every day? The government is acutely aware of the sensitivities around the issue. Internal emails obtained under Freedom of Information laws show the Foreign Office recognises what parallels could be drawn with the Windrush scandal. They also reveal that Foreign Office officials believed Amber Rudd, who was forced to step down as Home Secretary over Windrush, gave the Chagossian issue the brush off. Typical. The targeting of British Chagossians continued under Rudd's successor, Sajid Javid. Marie Lisby Elise was born on the island of Peros Banos in 1953, but forcibly evicted by colonial administrators in 1973. She travelled to The Hague last September to give evidence about her experience. Here she tells her story. In Chagos, everyone had a job, his family and his culture. All that we ate was fresh food. Ships which came from Mauritius brought all our goods. But one day, the administrator told us that we had to leave our island, leave our houses and go away. All persons were unhappy, but we had no choice. They did not give us any reason. Ships which used to bring our food stopped coming. We had nothing to eat, no medicine, nothing at all. We suffered a lot, but then one day, a ship called Navadir came. So quite a tragic story. But yeah, I mean, if British has given them British passports, they can't now tell them to get out. But that's what they're doing. And what can I say? Anyway, this is just useful information for those who are interested. Bye-bye.